Hello everyone, today I am going to be doing something different. I am starting a new series, General Conservation. This is where I talk about basic explanations of environmental conservation. Don't worry if you do not know what I'm talking about, you are about to see. Let's get started now. The first question you think about every time you start something new is, what is this new thing? Well, I am about to tell you what conservation is. It's really pretty simple and really fun to say. Conservation. Conservation means protection, usually talking about the protection and restoration of the planet, wildlife, and natural habitats. Some ways people help conserve the planet is by planting, recycling, and picking up trash. Other ways include conserving resources such as water, food, and energy, and educating the public. Conservation is super important because we only have one planet. So why don't y'all join in? I mean, what's stopping you? The environment has been dying from different threats, some that humans created. Speaking of threats are things that threaten the population of wildlife and more. For example, one threat to the planet is air pollution. When us humans burn fossil fuels, natural fuels from the earth, to create electricity and light homes. This may seem good, but burning fossil fuels creates air pollution, which can harm animals, humans, and plants. Another similar threat to this is water pollution. Water pollution is when trash, oil, or toxins get sent into different bodies of water, like oceans and lakes. This can harm marine animals who might mistake trash as food. Plants may get tangled in trash. Oil spills can tangle animals. In other words, water pollution is when things that don't belong in the ocean go into the ocean. Poaching is another threat that threatens the population of wildlife. Poaching means illegal hunting. Sometimes when humans need food or other resources from animals, poachers, also known as hunters, kill animals. But some of the time, that kill is unnecessary. Before I dive in deeper, I want you to think about it. Why are some of the kills unnecessary? Alright, so sometimes humans waste food that they didn't eat, or water that they didn't drink, or even energy. So after throwing away some resources we could have used or saved, poachers need to kill more animals to feed us. That is why I believe we should try not to waste too much resources. Try your best! A few other threats. Overfishing, when humans fish too much. Infrastructure, when humans build civilizations on natural habitats. And invasive species also and wildlife trade, when humans, sometimes by mistake, release non-native species out into the wild and trade living or dead species to different places of the planet. This can harm native wildlife. All of these threats endanger our planet. Sometimes threats we create can affect us too. Furthermore, air pollution can harm our health and make the climate warmer. This is called climate change. But let's branch out for a second. This whole time, I've been talking about some really sad things. There's still hope if we work fast. Here are some ways you can help to stop these threats. You can do simple things, or if you are really passionate, you can do some bigger things. For example, you can volunteer or work for cleanups in your community. The more, the merrier, or better. Raising awareness and educating people about the problems happening in our world can help a lot. You can't save something without knowing it is in trouble. Companies and organizations need money to do their job nicely. Raise money or donate money to organizations near you that help save Earth. Is this a little too much for you? Then why not do something simpler? It will still help so much. You can reduce, reuse, and recycle. Encourage your family and friends to do that too. Try to drive less. Cars burn gasoline to run, and that creates air pollution. Here's the simple but really important one. Don't waste resources. Wasting resources can result in unnecessary events or threats. These are all ways you can help. I find this the most important part of what I teach. I encourage you to do these. It can make you feel better about yourself, too. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope you learned something new today and that you were inspired to help. If you want to see more of this video, go to my website for interactive lessons that are so fun. In case you're new, I am the founder of Earth Matters. My mission in life is to make sure that humans and wildlife live together in harmony. I won't sacrifice humans for wildlife, and I won't sacrifice wildlife for humans. Every living thing on this planet, including plants and animals, deserves to live a good life. I guess you could say I'm a conservationist and activist. So join me on my mission to have a world of peace and harmony. Bye!